Welcome back, everyone. This is Spencer with PROMATION. Setting up an SMT production line can sometimes feel challenging and overwhelming. We have created this video tutorial today to assist you during the installation process of your new PCB handling equipment. Our methods are proven and used by industry professionals all over the world. Before diving in, please be sure to smash that like button and subscribe to stay updated with all the product launches and product introductions. If you're ready, I'm ready. Let's dive in.
Once you have uncrated your equipment, using a forklift will be the most efficient way of transporting and removing the machine from the pallet. Start by moving the machine to an open area. Now that you have your machine on the ground, start by taking a utility blade and or scissors and begin removing the shrink wrap from your machine. Feet locks will be located on each leg, securing the machine during transportation. Locate a drill and a Phillips bit and begin removing the feet locks from the pallet. After removing the feet locks, using the forklift, lift the machine and safely remove the pallet from under the machine. Now that your machine is on the ground, you can push the machine using the wheels under the machine, or you can use a pallet jack, lift the machine, and transport it to its designated area. Using a pallet jack, lower or raise the machine to match the appropriate height of the upstream machines. Now that you have the machine's height matched to the upstream machine, go to each leg and turn the leg to the right to lower the foot to the ground. Using a precision bubble level, ensure that the machine is properly leveled. It is important to note that when using a level, installers verify position using rail sets and not the machine's panels. Once satisfied with the machine's position, raise or lower the machine for the final adjustment. Once complete, use the locking nuts to lock the machine's height. To turn on the machine, engage the master power switch. The next step will be to adjust conveyor width in preparation of loading alignment PCBs. For auto width, users can select the appropriate width using the machine's touch panel. For manual width, adjust using the retractable hand crank. To ensure proper alignment, take two alignment PCBs and bring them side by side. Slowly pull them towards the front fixed rail to reduce the gap between the boards. Check for misalignment and skew between two sample PCBs. This can indicate a misaligned machine. If needed, adjust the machine's alignment and repeat the process again until the units are properly aligned. PCBs should be able to follow process flow from one station to the next without hiccups or catching an edge. Now that your machine is aligned, you can move the locking nut on the linear guide to the adjustable rail. Once this is set, the conveyor's width is now locked. To ensure your sensors are working properly, move your production board over the sensor and make sure the green and amber light are present once covered. If tuning is required, the top dial controls the range of the sensor and the bottom dial controls light adjustability. Always tune the sensor to be triggered only when a PCB is present. Connect your SMEMA cables to the appropriate up or downstream port. Pro tip: using different color communication cables can reduce improper connection. For units that require a compressed air hookup, a general recommendation of 72 PSI is ideal for nearly all models.
Thank you, everyone, for the continued support on PROMATION USA's YouTube channel. We hope you enjoy your new PROMATION PCB handling equipment. If you found today's video informative and educational, please be sure to leave a comment below. To view our full product line, visit us online at www.promationusa.com. Thanks for tuning in, and remember to go pro.